Hey everyone, I'm Selena Hill, founder of Be Heard Talk, and today I have the privilege to speak with Mr. Carl Clay. Mr. Carl Clay has been a significant force in the theater and independent film movement for decades, and his creative use of theater, film, video, and music has resulted in numerous awards. As founder and executive producer of Black Spectrum Theater, he has produced over 300 theatrical productions that have been performed in New York City and throughout the country. As the founder and CEO of Black Spectrum Theater, Mr. Clay has trained over 1,000 actors. His feature-length film is available on video. He's produced over 30 jazz concerts, with artists such as Carl Thomas and Roberta Flack. Mr. Clay has also produced, written, and directed a total of 20 short and feature-length films, several which are included in the video library. Thank you so much, Mr. Clay, for joining us here today.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure. First of all, let me say that I am so supportive and respectful and just appreciative of the work that you do. And so it's just an honor to be a part of this today, really.
Oh yes, and it's an honor to have you. You have quite an impressive portfolio and body of work over the last few decades. So I actually wanted to start there. If you can tell us about when and why you founded Black Spectrum Theater.
Well, I founded Black Spectrum Theater. I'm not going to say it was simple, but the impetus to begin it was very simple. It was visceral in the sense that, I was watching what was going on in the late '60s in the streets in Alabama and Mississippi, and like many others, I had an emotional response to it, having done a lot of reading about my people's history and my family's history and so forth. It was like, well, what can I do? And I realized that the tools that I had in my hand, as Adam Clayton Powell always says, look what's in your hands. Even though I wasn't quoting him back then, in retrospect, that's exactly what I did. It was look what's in your hand. And what I had was a real thirst for the creative arts. But at that time I realized that maybe you could marry those two, that interest in and understanding what was going on and using that as a tool to make change in a community and educate people and communicate to people.
So Mr. Clay, you're actually a staple in South Jamaica, Queens. How has the Black Spectrum Theater really served this community?
Well, over the years, it's occurred in several ways. When we first started out, it was, basically the work and putting together our ideas. One of our first productions, the first production we ever did was called actually Niggers. And the reason why we wrote that play, we wanted to trace that word all the way back to its origin in the 16th century and follow it up to today. A lot of people didn't like us with that name at the beginning. So we kind of changed that, but the group broke up and we came back and did a play called Black Love. And Black Love was something different in the early 70s. Because it didn't talk about, what other folks were doing to us. It just talked about how we could find love within ourselves and amongst each other to create a better community. And so that resonated. And since then, over the years, our goal has been to create works that are pertinent, have a pertinent significance to our community. We've grown, and I think become a staple, you can say our organization become a staple in the community because we've tried to be there for the different phases that our community has gone through, whether it was police brutality, whether it was health issues, whether it was employment issues, whether it was educational issues, and all of our productions have lent itself in some way, besides also providing quality entertainment. But, you know, when you put those two things together, it becomes edutainment, you know? And I think that's really it. I mean, we had the opportunity to move the theater into Manhattan. We had the opportunity to move it up on Jamaica Avenue. And we've always balked at that a bit because we just felt that if we can stay within the community and represent that energy around us, that the community will support us for years to come. And I think that some of that has, you know, it's proven itself over the years.
For sure. I do want to speed things up now to talk about what's going on today, because now we have the Black Spectrum Theater virtual subscription season, where folks, obviously we can no longer gather together because of COVID, but you are offering this digital component. Can you talk about the subscription season?
Sure. So normally in a normal year, we would have a subscription program that people could buy into, and they get so many plays, they can see all of our productions throughout the whole year. But since COVID and, you know, in the pandemic, what we did was, is we went back into our archives of over 100 videos of plays, concerts, interviews, and so forth. And pulled out about 20 of those and put it together as what we call Black Spectrum Theater at Home video series. And so that started back in October, and it will run to the end of February, and we're preparing for part two. We've shown productions, interviews with Dick Gregory, who came to our theater and did live talks and interviews with us for audiences about four or five times since the early 90s. So that was a real treasure of information coming from him. We've had concerts with people like Roy Ayers and Lonnie Liston Smith, Noel Pointer, a jazz artist. We've had folks like LL Cool J and Paul Simon visit the theater back in the day. We were doing our talent search program. John Lucien, the Caribbean master singer, as we know, who passed away some years ago, but he's a part of our archives. Plays like Two Trains Running, August Wilson's plays, Fences, and Celeste Bedford Walker's plays, Sassy Mama, and Once in a Wifetime, about a guy who comes home and decides he wants to tell his wife that he wants a second wife, which is a comedy drama, but with a lot of messages in it. So we've done musicals, Five Guys Named Mo, and we just have a number of works, a youth program works, Who You Least Expect, about drugs in our schools, and Urban Encounters, What to Do If You Get Stopped by the Police. That's a film that we did back in the early 2000s. So we have a wealth of information. What we do is we select pieces out of that and make it a part of this at-home video series. And, people pay a very minimal price. You know, going into our second phase, it's like $19.95. You get four of these videos a month, $49.99 for 3 months. You get all the videos, 11 videos for that. So it's our way of allowing people to catch up with some of the things they might have missed at Black Spectrum, as well as just learn more about what we do and how we do what we do, you know?
Mr. Clay, another thing I wanted to ask you about is, what do you think is the future of theater? And why is it still so important for us to be able to watch live entertainment in this way?
Okay, that's a good question. And it really, really cuts to the heart of something that I believe deeply. And that is that with all of the technology and electronics and satellites moving around our head, and electric cars, and every kind of gizmo you can think of that now has a smart component connected to it, the human element, I don't think will ever disappear. People want to have that personal connection. And, you know, theater's been around for thousands of years in one form or another. And I think it's here to stay. And I think what we have is basically like an intermission going on, you know, with the COVID and the pandemic. But I believe it's going to return, and it's going to return with a vengeance, because people want to be next to each other. People want to experience that, you know, like, you know, you can be watching a theater production and somebody laughs in the audience, and, you know, people don't talk about this much, but even the way they laugh can be a part of the show, you know, or some actor on stage looks out in an audience, you believe, hey, they're talking to me, you know? So all of those kinds of experiences you can't get electronically, you know, it's a live experience, and thank God it's a live experience. And I don't think that's gonna go anywhere. I think that that's gonna come back, and people are dying for that to come back.
We sure are. Well, in the interim, please let everyone know how they can get their Black Spectrum Theater subscription season today.
Sure. You can go to www.blackspectrum.net. You can call us at 718-723-1800. We are on Facebook, but nevertheless, on our website, that's where you can, you know, connect and get a subscription, or you can call us directly and call our box office and leave a message, and we'll get back to you for, you know, to talk to you about getting a subscription. And like I said, part two will begin in, after part one finishes in the end of February, part two will begin in March. And we have folks like John Lucien, the review for Ray Charles, A Conversation with Vivica Fox, who came to the theater. We have a piece on Aretha Franklin, a wonderful piece that comes out of Atlanta, a piece called Kingfish Meets the 21st Century. A lot of us remember Kingfish and the Amos and Andy show. It was banned. But what we did was, is we brought it back and retooled it and put it in a 21st century context. And so that's a play that will be there, as well as Doo-Wop Love. And, you know, and a lot of great music, additional music that will be a part of this. So yeah, check us out. You know, we're celebrating our 50th year of operation, and we continue to be proud of our past and excited about all the opportunities are there for the future.
Yes, thank you so much again, Mr. Clay. We appreciate working with you. We appreciate your commitment to the community, and we appreciate the work you're doing to keep theater alive. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and we appreciate you and all the work that you're doing. You are bringing up the rear, as they say, bringing it, throwing it down in the current time, and planning for the future. And I am just proud of the work that you guys are doing. I really am. And in any way we can be helpful, we'd like to do some things with you, okay? So, you know, with that said, thank you so much.
Yes, thank you.